Many of us, including me, are intimidated by colorful eyeshadows. Hi everyone, it's Smitha, and today I'm going to be showing you 9 different ways to incorporate colorful eyeshadows in your everyday looks to make it more wearable. So if you're ready, let's begin. For today's looks, I'm going to be using the Doe Color Tropical Palette. It's an affordable palette, has all the colors and some beautiful neutrals as well, and I've linked it down below. For the first look, I'm starting with a neutral brown shade. You can use any neutral shade. You can use a cool toned, more like a grayish brown, or you can just use a warm brown. And I'm using it in my crease as well as lower lash line because this is going to be my transition shade. At the crease, I use the Sigma E40 blending brush, and for my lower lash line, I'm using a small, flat, fluffy brush because I don't want to buff it out too much. And now for the colored eyeshadow, I'm going to be using a matte yellow eyeshadow in the inner corner. You can use a matte, metallic, satin, whatever you prefer. And this is a nice way to combine it with neutral eyeshadows to make it more wearable. And to apply it, I'm using a small flat shader brush. And I'm going to finish up with some mascara. This is probably one of the most common and a fantastic way to add a pop of color to your everyday looks. For the next look, I'm going to be starting with a color. I'm using a mint green color right in the center of the lid. You can of course tweak any of the looks and you can use any color that you prefer. You don't have to use the same exact colors that I'm using. You can use the color that goes well with your outfit. And then to neutralize this and balance it out, I'm going to be using the neutral brown shade in the inner and outer corners. And then I'm going to be repeating the same in my lower lash line using the color in the center and the neutral shades in the corners. I finish this look again with some mascara, and this gives you that beautiful pop of color right in the center, making it a stunning halo eye. For the third look, I'm going to first start with a cool kajal in my waterline as well as lash line, and then I'm going to smudge and smoke it out, creating a smoky liner. I'm just using a simple eye pencil by Wet n Wild, and again, I'm linking everything down below in the description box. And then using a flat definer brush, I'm going to smudge this out. Also, if you're looking for an all-in-one brush set that's not expensive, I have been using the Doe Color brush set for about 6 years now, and it still works great. You would have seen me use it in every single tutorial. I'm going to link that down below in the description box as well. And now for that pop of color, I'm using a brick red shade right above the smudged coal in my lash line. And to apply it, I'm using a small, flat, firm brush. And that makes it a very sultry, smoky, smudge liner moment with a pop of color, which looks absolutely stunning. And if you're an absolute beginner, the easiest way to apply eyeshadow is just to apply it on your lids. I'm going to be doing a color wash using a light matte mint shade. Now you can also use a metallic shade. And all I'm going to do is push it outward in the outer corner just to give me that elongated eye look. And to draw some light and to make my eyes look brighter, I'm going to highlight the inner corner with a highlighter. You can also use a light metallic shade. These monotone eye looks look fantastic, especially if you're wearing a solid silk or a chiffon. Try doing this look if you have that in your outfit, and I bet you it'll look fantastic. Next, for a captivating eye with a pop of color, I'm going to start with the neutral brown shade as my transition. Using the Sigma E40 blending brush, I'm going to blend it out in the outer corner. And now for color, I'm going to be using a blue eye pencil in my lower waterline. This eye pencil is from the Color Outside the Liner set from ColourPop. And right underneath that, I'm going to smoke out the same color eyeshadow. To finish up, I'm using some mascara. This is the Roller Lash by Benefit Cosmetics. And here is the completed look. Using a colored eye pencil or a liner or even an eyeshadow in the lower lash line and waterline makes your eyes so much more captivating. For this next look, again, I'm starting with the neutral brown shade as my transition in the outer corner and the outer crease, again using my Sigma E40 blending brush. I'm doing a light wash, dragging some of that color towards the inner part of the lid as well. And right beside it, I'm going to use color. And I'm just using a matte purple shade here. Again, you can use any color that you want. I'm only going to use it in the outer half of my lid, keeping my inner half open. And I'm going to finish up with some mascara. You're welcome to highlight your inner corner if you like. I just wanted to keep every look different, so I'm going to leave it open. And this in itself makes your eyes look so much bigger and brighter. And it also gives you that beautiful smoky effect. And for this next look, I'm going to be using a matte pink eyeshadow as my transition. Using a blending brush, I'm going to blend it out in the outer corner as well as the crease. To finish up, I'm going to be using a black mascara in my upper lashes. I'm using the Bad Girl Bang mascara by Benefit Cosmetics. And in my lower lashes, I'm going to be using a mascara that matches my transition shade, a pink mascara. This is the Pink Ink BFF mascara by ColourPop. And as you can see, it's not overwhelming, it doesn't look crazy, it goes really well with the transition shade, and it's a very wearable look. If you like to glam things up, you can always combine a color with gold eyeshadow. First, I'm going to wash a gold eyeshadow all over my lid with a flat shader brush. And then I'm going to be using a matte red eyeshadow in the inner corner, dragging it towards the center of the lid. So that mixes with the gold eyeshadow to give you that beautiful metallic red eyeshadow in the inner corner. To balance everything out, I'm going to finish up with the neutral brown transition shade. You're welcome to use any transition shade that you like. I just wanted to keep it consistent throughout, so I'm using the brown shade. I'm going to use it at the crease as well as my lower lash line. So using a color that matches your outfit with a gold eyeshadow will amp up any look, especially if you want to do a very simple eyeshadow look for special events. You don't have much time. Just pop in a gold and pop in a color. And if you like something that's timeless and classy, I'm going to start with a winged liner. The eyeliner that I'm using is the e.l.f. liquid liner. And then I'm going to double wing it using a purple eyeshadow by using it right below the wing. And a tip here is to use a concealer right underneath your wing before you apply the eyeshadow to make the color pop even more. And those are 9 different ways to use color and still make it wearable in your everyday looks. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you did. And do check out the description box for all the goodies, including all the products that I used and my social media links. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.